beyond the power of the human mind to comprehend.
Alright, I think I got this set up. Hey, how's it going, man? What's going on, Alex? Can you hear me okay? Can you hear the music alright? Can you let me know, please? I tried testing this, excuse me, I'm gonna cough real quick. Excuse me. I tried testing this microphone and it's not doing as good as I was hoping. It's not a good quality one, but I'm just trying to get something going. How you doing today, man? How's your Monday going? If you can, Alex RC. Hello, good old friend. How can I hear? And I can hear your mic and music. Nice. Thank you. I appreciate that. Yeah, last time the video at the beginning for like the first 23 minutes was just nothing but static. So I wanted to make sure it was working this time. I appreciate you tuning in, man. How have you been? I hope all is well. We're gonna get started here. So when I spawned in now from the last video, the last time I streamed a couple days ago, I was prepping the trap horse farm. Now for jack-o'-lantern mobs on Halloween, which only happens one time a year. So essentially I have farms that I really only use and need one time a year, which for most is tedious and not worth the time or effort. But for me personally, what I like to do on this world, these are the challenges I set myself for to go for. Best home security of 2022 by US News and World Report. But we don't Let's do what see. We do for the accolades. So when we spawn in now, I have the last time I saved it was right before a thunderstorm. So that when I spawn in now, I'm right when a thunderstorm is happening at the farm. So I try and get as much time utilized and making it as efficient as possible. So I'm not trying to wait there for a thunderstorm. I saved it a few days ago and haven't played on purpose. So as soon as I spawn in, I'm right in the thunderstorm. Good. I'm builder. You've been building a lot in your world? I hope you've still been playing, man. So let me go ahead and start this in. Spawn in. It should take a couple of seconds to render everything in. But once it does, it should have a lightning storm going. And for those that may be tuning in for the first time, we're coming across these kind of videos for the first time. This farm is a 300 by 300 radius, like area on the map above an ocean, where I came across that lightning strikes more than normal when unloading and reloading chunks in this area for some reason. So I wanted to try and take advantage of it for a trap horse farm. And when the thunder starts going, it should be going here in a couple of seconds, I think. But when the storm starts going, I have increased my chances and odds at getting trap horses to spawn more frequent than just normally when wandering around the game in the map. Think about how rare it is when there's a lightning storm to begin with, and then how much more rare it is when you get a trap horse to actually spawn in next to you. This one, I usually roughly get about 4 on average trap horses. So when they open up, that's 12 skeleton horsemen that spawn in. So it really increases the chances. It's not, you know, super, super fast or efficient, but it's more than what it would be if I was just playing and waiting for a random chance to happen. Alex says, yes, I have a lot, and so has my 68 villagers for trading nonstop. Dang, that's a lot, man. Jeez. Are you on a Bedrock version, or are you on the PS4 still? Dang, I haven't done nothing with villagers for a while. Ever since, sheesh, what update was it? 1.13? When they changed the villager mechanics. couple years ago, I haven't done really anything with villagers. All my villager system broke, and all the trading got reset. Actually, not even reset. Everything just changed and reset back to normal. Like as if I never traded with them before, and their trades were completely different than when I first made the villager trading area. All right, here we go. Here goes some lightning going. So when we go this way, the farm should start making the lightning go a lot faster and more frequent than if it was just wandering around normally. So hopefully we'll get some in. I'm on PS4 now and in 119. Okay, cool. Have you been having any problems with that one? I always come across people saying that they're having issues with every time there's an update. Even the updates on Bedrock are breaking the legacy version. It's hard for me to travel through the Nether now because I have shulker boxes everywhere. And since the recent updates, it's affected this to where shulker boxes really lag out an area to where I even got to I get kicked from the game a lot of the times. So much lag, yeah, definitely. That's too bad, man. There's so many cool things that can happen with Bedrock, and so many new mobs, and so much new game mechanics, and just different things that could be done. But it's very difficult to go ahead and do it when there's this lag and you can't even play. Like, I remember when Bedrock first came out, I was so excited to try an update. And when I tried to update this world, it was completely broken. Completely broken. And then it happened for months and months that it was just like that, and I just says, forget it, I'm just gonna stay on this version. I already have enough that I have planned that I could play for like at least the next 5, 6 years nonstop. So I wouldn't have to upgrade. All the stuff that I want to do is able to be done on this version anyway. Like, even this farm, I don't think it works as efficient as it would on Bedrock compared to here. If at all. I haven't seen any horses spawn in yet. I have a couple of other setups I'm trying to test on here to try and make the lightning more frequent, but to where it'll want to spawn in trap horses. Right now, this farm is the way I have it set up now, has probably been the most efficient that I've come across that I've tested out. Another idea I had is like staying within like a 20 block radius and unloading and reloading a smaller amount of chunks more frequently, causing the lightning to almost be non-stop, like to where the sky is completely lit up every time there's a lightning strike. But I don't get no trap horses to spawn in. There'll be lightning strikes completely around the player, all over this area, but nothing will spawn in, unfortunately. So it's just a lot of trial and error. Dang, still no horses. You're trying to make a chunk loader. Nice. I think on Bedrock, I think those do work. That's something that I wish would work on this, because then I would have different areas loaded all the time. But everything that I've tried, even my own ideas, just they don't work on here, unfortunately. Dang, hopefully you can get that going. That'd be pretty sweet. What do you plan on using? What kind of farm are you planning to have, or area are you planning to have constantly loaded? Hopefully some horses just spawned right there by the beacon. That was a close strike. Dang, nothing. we don't get a few, I might just have to go ahead and exit the game without saving and restart and see, so we can go ahead and be back at the lightning storm again. Unfortunately, I haven't found a way to go ahead and speed up weather patterns on here. But I'm probably not supposed to anyway. That'd be messing with the game too much. I'm surprised there hasn't even been one that spawned in yet. Oh, there comes one. Alright, it'll probably open on our way back. Once we're close enough. Last time I was playing, I had to clear out a bunch of about between 35 and 40 trap horses to try and clear the mob cap around here because nothing else was spawning in. But then now that it's clear, nothing's spawning in, only one so far. I'm trying to get all of that chunk loaded up without costing me more lag. What area are you trying to have constantly loaded, or what type of farm? That's the end of the storm. Let's see what this one spawns in anyway. There's one jack-o'-lantern, two gold ones. Let's just stop here so they can flow in faster. I'll probably just reset. Dang, that stinks.
Global business consulting solutions for a constantly transforming world. That's Protivity. Flexible, results-driven, and committed to you. That's Protivity. Custom solutions shaped for your company's unique needs. That's
Protivity. The jack-o'-lantern one?
Protivity helps more than 70% of the Fortune 1000 run better today and change for tomorrow.
Gold helmet.
Learn more at protivity.com/shape. That's protivity.com/shape.
Yeah, almost.
A new chapter for listening is here with audiobooks on Spotify. Now, you can explore
see how they look
more
down
than
here.
300,000 audiobooks from genres and authors you love, all in one
place. Well, I'll have to try again.
And it's easy to
but while they come down, from the last time I had this,
to unlock titles, tap the banner to learn
showcase
more.
From the last video, I changed it up quite a bit and really refined how it looked in here. So I don't get so many horses piled up where I don't want them. And as well as so I can have room to walk around and just have it look more cleaned up, I guess. It looks a lot different, but we can see what horses we got here. I think there's two more coming down. Yeah, here it comes. So watch, this is how I have it set up now. Let's see, here's my stuff. Whoops. We'll just go through these ones and check them out anyway, and then I'll just go ahead and reset and try again. Unfortunately, a thunderstorm only comes, every couple of days that I play in real life. They don't happen that often. So when it does, I really gotta try and, take advantage of it and save the time. Let's see, I'm trying to... Oh, never mind. Thought you had replied. Let's see. Let me go ahead and, I'll break this one. This is something I gotta fix right here. To try and get them come one at a time instead of twice. Or even multiple at a time. Just a regular one. No shoes on this guy. Just gold helmet. Alright, I'm just gonna go ahead and reset on this. The trading system. Oh, okay, the trading system. Oh, dang. Yeah, oh, dang. I bet that causes a lot of lag. I thought you were talking about a different farm you may have going. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and reset this real quick. Exit without saving. Yeah, that villagers like that. Sheesh, that's gonna... That does take up a lot. Especially if you have other things around the area. But what could I ask real quick? What are you trying to have it loaded constantly for a villager trading area when the player will be needed there to be trading? Unless you're gonna have other farms there. Because it would not to like throw shade at your idea or nothing, but if you're trying to have an area loaded and a player is required to be there to trade, then you're gonna cause yourself a necessary lag by having a full area loaded when there's no reason, there's no other farms there, or no there's no automatic villager trading system unless there's a player there. If you understand what I mean. Let's see how this one goes. Hopefully this one does a lot better. Dang, that was some horrible odds. Yeah, I think the absolute most I've gotten at one time for a rain the lightning storm is 5 trap horses. Usually I average between 3 and 4. Mostly 4. Plus a raid farm. Okay. Yeah, that's something I need to do on here too, is a raid farm. I have some ideas. I'm trying to come across other ideas and then try and see if I can incorporate my ideas into that somehow. But I just haven't really put no full effort as I should into it yet. I was doing it at one point, but then I just gave up. What kind of raid farm idea are you going with? As well as what kind of trading system you got going? Get some good luck. I even try to make it, if you notice on the train tracks, I have it where it slows down and then speeds me up just enough, and then slows me down and then speeds me up enough. That's to go ahead and through all the testing I've done. It probably could be more efficient though, but through the testing I've done, this is the best that works for loading and unloading the chunks and getting the trap horses to spawn in. I had it at one point when I was testing that I had me go as fast as I could across the tracks to where I was constantly having lightning and nothing spawned in though, because I was unloading chunks too quick behind me. So where lightning was really happening a lot, it wasn't having enough time for the area to be rendered in and for mobs to be spawned in. I was unloading it too quickly. So this took some trial and error. But I could probably even get better. I just gotta put some effort into it again. Let's see, right now I have a 64 by 64 trading hall. Nice. How many villagers you got going there? Do you have the do you have any wandering traders there as well? Ooh, there comes one in already. Out there in the distance. That might be one too as well. All right, let's hope we get 5. That little marker I have way out there. I have come across it the other day. There is a exposed what's it called? Spider spawner in the water. So I thought that was pretty cool. Oh, here comes that horse. Ooh, dang, it might not open till we get over there. I might have to open it real quick. Because if it opens before, while we're down there, it might pop the horses out of the holding cell. And then they'll be everywhere. Alright. Thirty-six villagers, and yes, wandering traders too. Nice, nice, dude, nice. Sweet, man. I might have to check that out. It'd be good. Try if you can send me some screenshots if you don't mind, dude. I'd like to check that out. Whenever you get a chance, whenever you get a chance, that'd be. I like to see other people's ideas and what they got going, because then that also gives me inspiration and motivation. You plan on having any other kind of farms there? You probably could, since well, I don't know, that's a lot of villagers there. And the raid farm. You could probably have smaller farms there that, you know, do like crops, auto crop farms and stuff. Just so you have something constantly building while that area is being constantly loaded. That's what I try and do now, since there's no chunk loader, is what I do on here. Like when I'm not streaming or whatever, I'll go ahead and load in two players, my other account, and I'll use that as my chunk loader. So I could be here. How was I doing it before? What's one of the things I did? That's one thing I did. I had one player at main spawn, where I have most of my big farms. I have sugarcane farm, I have a pumpkin and melon farm, I have a mob farm, I have what else is there? There's a few other ones. A big crop farms, villager crop farm, and a few other ones. And then I'll have my second player loading the end dimension, where I have my enderman farm. It's the Enderman farm that connects to the overworld. So I can have the Enderman farm running, the Obsidian farm running in the End Dimension, and then everything in the overworld running. The only thing that kind of that's crummy about that is I had to play split screen when I do that. So when I do play it, I usually just let it sit overnight and just let it all run in the background. That's what I used to do with the witch farm too. I'd have a player at the witch farm and then a player at the gold farm in the nether. This way no mob cap is taken up, and the gold farm can run at max rate, and then the other farms can run at max rate. The witch farm can run at max rate. But right now I have 1,185 emerald blocks too. Jeez. That's a ton, dude. That's a lot. Oh yeah, that's a lot of trading you've been doing then. I think I only got like maybe 4 emerald blocks. If that. Come on, skeleton horses.
Meta brings people and businesses together, and businesses and their ambitions closer. How? Connections can take your business anywhere. So meet new audiences, meet powerful tools, meet opportunity, meet Meta.
Come on, gotta get at least two more. Hopefully that one down there was a jack-o'-lantern.
What about 10
a lit up pumpkin head. No, that's it already. What? Come on. This game's juking me.
Listen now.
There's been times where I sat there working on the farm down there, and there was at least two sets that spawned in, and that's just for me standing there. This time I'm running the whole farm, and I only get one that spawns in. Come on, game. Dang, it already went. Nice. That's so nice. This guy's splashing. I'm sorry, horsey. Let's just see what this one is real quick. Oh no, it's a regular pumpkin head. Alright, I'm just gonna reset real quick. Exit without saving. Alright. Dang it. Survival. Well, that was worth this another try. I'm hoping at least this run this once, get one or two jack-o'-lantern heads, and then that should be good. I'm not expecting much, but I'm hoping to at least get one or two. Mine carts are twice as slow, they can be outrun by a player. Yeah, that's true. Yeah. I have ideas for using minecarts on top of the nether roof to transport myself in the new Minecraft version. Minecarts are twice as oh yeah, that's right. They're like on a Java edition, I believe. I remember when I first started playing Minecraft, probably like, geez, 7 years ago, I used to watch the tutorials from Java players, computer edition, and I would notice their builds, when they would make them with like doing like a minecart track or whatever, or something with train tracks and minecarts, that they would have to use a lot of powered rails to get going quick. And so when I would make my farm to copy theirs, exactly how it was, with exactly how many powered rails, I would go way, way too quick to where the farm would never work, and it would be real discouraging until I realized when they use like 8 minecarts, powered rails, I'm able to use one and get the same amount of speed, if not more. These powered rails are super quick on here. They're actually a little too efficient on this version. I think that's what should have been done on here. I think that it's better for minecarts to be slower. And then ways to go ahead and increase the speed if possible with more powered rails. This way it encourages the player to to work harder. Or not harder, but to go ahead and so it's more of a challenge for the player to acquire that kind of speed or momentum for transportation or whatever. I don't know, that's just how I feel. I think it gives a good challenge, because then you gotta earn to try and get that speed. Was that one coming in? Nope. I should have had one horse already, come on. Comes a guardian. Almost died earlier the other day. A guardian fell down and started shooting me when I was AFK. I didn't even realize it got down there. There comes one. And then these train tracks with the power rails, I try to set it up to where I go slow going this way, but when I go back, I go twice as fast to try and get back to the starting point, because if you notice, lightning doesn't strike when I'm unloading the chunks back this way and reloading these ones yet. It only works going the opposite way. So no lightning strikes have happened yet. But when I double back, then it starts going. Come on, the sun's already rising. Come on. Let's see what opened up here. It's almost like a prize. I don't know what I'm gonna get. Most of the time, it's nothing worthwhile. A regular one, full armor. I mean, iron armor. Nope. Come on. Be two of them, hopefully. They'll even spawn way out there at the very corner of the farm. It'll take about 5 minutes to flush in. That was none. What? That should have been two of them. So I'm in my Minecraft world, and I have to wait 5 to 10 minutes for it to load up. Jeez. Are you on a realm, by chance? Do you have your world set up as a realm? And, that should have been one. Yeah, that is one. Do you have your world... Does it do the same thing, lag when you're playing online or offline as well? Nothing... That's how this one gets. If I load up, or now, if I don't save it in a spot where there's, if I save it in a spot and exit where there's a ton of shulker boxes and try and load back in another time, oh no, I won't be able to load in. My game will keep crashing. I got lucky. I was able to let it was loaded me in, so then I had to go ahead and save somewhere where there's nothing around.
If you have certain chronic conditions,
so when I load in, I get a chance to go ahead and move around. If I go into the Nether, it takes forever to load up. Here comes another one. That'll probably open up on our way back. Excuse me. Yeah, I'm trying to use Spotify on here, and every like four songs it plays a commercial, like four commercials. Ooh, just a regular pumpkin. Nope, not on Realms because there is too many griefers and hackers. Yeah, that sucks, man. That's another issue I heard with a lot of people having. And then anybody could just join, even if you have it blocked. Dang, that's unfortunate that has to happen. Like, they made it to where they have a chance to go ahead and have online communities. How do I say this? Online communities have a better chance to go ahead and play together, I guess. They have a wider range of, I guess, worlds and realms and different people's areas, you know, different creations to go ahead and play. But then, if they have it to where anyone could just join whenever they want, and especially have cheats on and modifications, and that just ruins it. And then you gotta pay for those realms too. That's another thing. That's a ripoff. That's what happens on some of the other games I play. They have it to where they entice you to have to spend all kinds of money to play online and buy your character skins, and like how Minecraft does too. But then there's nothing but cheaters online and hackers and modders, and it just ruins the game. All the hard work you try and put into it, and it just ruins it. Let's see what's here. Gold helmet. I think this is the most horses, though. They're gonna get stuck down there. They're gonna pop open. I need to think about how I could fix that. Oh, here comes another one, too. Dang. This is the most horses so far. There might even be another one that just spawned in over there. I play Minecraft on normal. On the normal world, you play by yourself. Oh, that's cool, that's cool. Yeah, that's how I play here, too. Well, that's cool, you still got it going, man. A lot of, let's see what's in this one real quick. Full leather armor. A lot of people I used to play with now, they won't play Minecraft unless it's on someone's realm. And most of the time, it's not even their, not even a, like one of their friends' realms. It's one of those big popular ones where there's like 4,000 people playing or whatever. People changed, yo. They changed. They changed. There comes another one. That's like 5 or 6 horses already. And only one pumpkin one. Come on. Alright, well, this still some better luck. That might even been one over there. Nope. This one won't open until we come back. This is a good run right here, but too bad there's no jack-o'-lantern ones. I think it was last year to where I came over here and I ran it for like an hour doing the same thing I'm doing now, and I didn't get any. Maybe I got one. Maybe one. After doing it constantly and constantly, that was how the luck is. So with even lightning storm, even rainstorms being rare, lightning storms be even more rare. A lightning strike to happen be even more rare close to the player. And then for that lightning strike to have a trap horse be spawned in is even more rare. There comes another one. And then here's another one. Here's that one below us. Oh, dang, there's two more. That thing's going to be loaded down there. And then for the pumpkin-headed ones to spawn in is even more rare. And then for a jack-o'-lantern one to spawn in is even rarer than that. Dang, there's all kinds spawning in. Oh, here's another one. I'll get that one on the way back. That's like 7 or 8 of them. So usually when I'll play, if I'm looking for to try and get something rare, when it's not like a Halloween thing like this, I'll wait for a good storm like this and save it right like how I did when we loaded up, and try and keep running it until I see what I get. And usually when there's a good chance like this, 4 or 5 horses that spawn in, I usually get one with gold armor or something. That's what I'll save. But this one, this is like 7 or 8 already. Yeah, it's hitting lag when we're coming back too. There's a lot of entities down there now. See what this one has. Iron helmets. So you figure that's like 8 times 4. There's already 24 skeleton horses that are going to be down there. Through one 10-minute thunderstorm. Does Sony even have any pumpkin jack-o'-lantern ones? Nope. And no, dang, they're both pumpkins. Regular pumpkins. Was that one? No. Well, sometimes it might be one. They just haven't rendered in yet. Whoa, the lag. But the bad thing about this one is all these horses spawning in, all this good luck, but there's no jack-o'-lantern ones that I'm looking for.
Ago, a splint was an innovative device that significantly improved orthopedic care. Today, Loveless Medical Group offers a full range.
There's gonna be a bunch down there.
Using highly advanced technology from sports.
Let's see if anything else spawned in way at the end over here.
And board-certified orthopedic surgeons provide you with a quicker recovery that will get you back to your best life. Call 505-727-2727.
Nothing.
Loveless, a century of
nothing.
Care.
Oh, there is one. There comes another one. Like 9 or 10 that spawned in. That's a good run right there. But not what we're looking for still. Even the farm has me being a farm, having to go back and forth, and wait. What the heck? And also, Minecraft has a new glitch, the rain and thunder glitch, that does it constantly until it stops for the 10th. Minecraft day. No kidding. Dang, how do you get that to work? Oh, that's right. They have things. Don't they have things where they have lightning rods? Is that a thing on Bedrock? Or is that only through mods? Dang, that'd be pretty interesting. Imagine this thing running for 10 Minecraft days. There'd probably be 100 horses down there. Here comes another one. No jack-o'-lantern. Anything else coming out here? Nope. I'm gonna have to check that out. That get that lightning going for 10 Minecraft days. Cause some, you know what? To be honest, I've watched, especially when Minecraft first came to Bedrock. There were certain things in the Bedrock Edition that still worked on this version. So I was able to go ahead and get ideas from glitches from a different version and try and come up with a way to get them to work on this version, if that makes any sense. So I'm going to have to look that up. One thing that I had been trying to get was the Nether Portal block. The pinkish-purple part that you go into. And get that obtained as a block, but unfortunately I haven't been able to get that legit in survival. I can't even get it in where's those horses at? Did they already go down? I don't want to fly down there and then they render in and I get shot or they shoot each other. They must have already. What was I even saying? Ooh, I forgot what I was saying. Let's go take a look. I don't think I'm gonna save this one. There were no jack-o'-lantern ones, but I just want to see how it looks down here. Oh yeah, that's what I was talking about. Getting ideas from other versions on glitches and oh, see, they could see me. Shoot. See, that's a problem right here. Is if they come down too much, it shoves them out. Dang it. Alright, I'm gonna have to find a way to fix that. Luckily, there's no jack-o'-lantern ones in here. Well, that kind of stinks. That's a lot of horses. I might have to get, if something like this happens and there are jack-o'-lantern ones, I'm gonna have to go ahead and go get a potion of invincibility. So that I can come in here and they won't shoot at me and shoot each other on accident. Dang, none of them are jack-o'-lanterns. That was probably the most horses I've ever had spawned in, though. That was almost 9 or 10 of them. 9 of them, I think it was what it was. Let me just double check in here. I don't think any of those were. No, they're not. Let's see, Alex said, yes, we have lightning rods, but they are finicky to work with. That'd be pretty interesting. I'm gonna go ahead and back out of this and try again. Exit without saving. I always gotta make sure I exit without saving. Yeah, I'm gonna have to look into that. I had seen a few years ago when I was looking to do a charged creeper farm. Jeez, probably like 5 years ago. I had seen on Java version that people had come up with ways to increase lightning strikes more often using end rods, almost like how a lightning rod would be, I guess. But I could never get anything to work on this version like that. I have come across players that are play on the Java edition that make trap horse farms, and this is where I got the ideas from, where these players, but they found ways to go ahead and manipulate the weather and alter the weather by unloading and reloading chunks with redstone mechanics, I guess, how to say, I don't know how they do it. But using redstone to load chunks, like I guess like with chunk loaders, yeah, to load chunks and unload chunks. So it tricks the game to thinking that certain events are happening in the game when it's really not. And so that increases the time in the game. Not the time, but the weather mechanics, the time that weather happens. That's pretty wild. If people are able to think of stuff like that on a game, I can only imagine people that have resources, money, manpower and capabilities to go ahead and try something of that nature in real life. I would not doubt if people try it. If people are able to try it in Minecraft, why not people try it in real life? Playing Minecraft is almost like playing real life. You spawn into nature with nothing. And what you do with it is, and what happens is from what you do. Come on, lightning strike. How long has this been going for? Almost an hour. I'm gonna turn up this the brightness. Make it a little easier to see. Hopefully we can get at least one. I'm just hoping for one. That'd be cool to have one, or at least maybe two. There comes one. Two jack-o'-lantern ones. Music back up a little bit. that's one at least so far. Hopefully that has this 4 jack-o'-lanterns in it, then I can call it a day right here. That should be one. Hopefully. Nope, nothing. Oh, there comes another. Or is that the same one? That's, oh no, here it is. That might be one. This might be a jack-o'-lantern one, let's see. Well, they're spawning another one.
I'm getting vaccinated.
Whoa,
with
so am I, because I'm at risk for pneumococcal pneumonia.
I'm asking about Prevnar 20, because there's a chance pneumococcal pneumonia could put me in the hospital.
Kind of lower this, jeez.
You may be at increased risk for pneumococcal pneumonia. Ask your doctor or pharmacist about getting
vaccinated. My goodness, that scared the heck out of me. Oh, there was another one. Talk about a Halloween scare. Those commercials scared the sneez out of me. Oh, that's a dolphin. Sorry, dolphin. Nine. I don't even think that was a jack-o'-lantern when it was a, had a leather cap. Come on. Oh, he seen me and he shot him. Ooh, they're fighting now. Good thing that's not a jack-o'-lantern. He spawned in and seen me and insta-shot. Anything you got going on today for the holiday? Alex, if you're still here in the chat. Come on. Hopefully that's a good one. Alex says, but the game does not like a massive item sort does not like massive item sorters when there's tons of item frames and redstone. Yeah, I agree. I have a on my at the main spawn. I have an item sorter, a big item sorter there, and there is a lot more lag with it. Dang, that stinks. It's already over. That was a shorter lightning storm than the last one. So even that's random with loading in each time. The length of the storm. That was way shorter than last time. Yeah, item frames. from what I understand, are like how like boats are item frames, and when you throw like items like that and throw them off and they're just hanging there on the floor, those are all like counted as entities and count towards how much the game can handle being loaded and rendered in. Even lighting updates. Like, if you had redstone lamps or redstone torches that are constantly flickering on and off in a dark area, so it's causing that area to light up and light back down and be lit up and be unlit. All that causes lag too in the long run. I've had a lot of issues. Where was it working at? Where was it at? What farm was that? I can't remember what farm it was, but I've had issues with that where I had to go ahead and either add torches around the area to light up the area so it's not constantly flickering on. What am I doing? Flickering on and off. Let's see what there is. Whoa, he could see me? Oh, he got out. I'm gonna get beasted. There's a jack-o'-lantern. I mean, a pumpkin one there. I just think it's a pumpkin. Oh, yeah, it's just a pumpkin. I gotta put more glass around here somehow. They keep popping out right here. Right here, I think. Yeah, I think it's right here they're able to get out. Right here. That's a big enough gap. Dang it, I might have to put a glass there instead. Actually, that'll probably be better. Alright. Exit again. But I'm not doing anything on Halloween Day. Oh, that's cool, that's cool. Yeah, I don't really do anything either. Probably take the little ones to do a little trick-or-treating. But that's it. Maybe pass out a little bit of candy. Maybe hunt for some Halloween mobs. I need to find a way to where if it doesn't recognize there's a jack-o'-lantern one, it automatically exits without saving and restarts it. This way I can just put the controller down and it just runs it automatically. Some good luck on this one. Even if it's just one, I'm just hoping for one. Come on, come on. One of the hard things I've come across with testing ideas to sort the trap horses is that I can't, if I go in like a creative copy of this world to do some testing, I can't even spawn in trap horses, skeleton horses, with the skeletons on them in creative. There's no spawning for that, so it's hard to do testing with trying to figure out where they fit and how big of an area they need and what causes them to get hurt or how tall they are. So I had to really be creative with how I get creative on things. Is that Is that lightning sound too loud? If you don't mind me asking. I remember one time I was playing and I was doing the wither farm. The obsidian farm, and I went back to watch the video to see how the sound came out. And I had the volume, I guess, way too high, even though it was only at like 5. And the wither explosions were just way too loud. It was super, super loud. To where you couldn't even hear me talking. And I only had the volume at 5. Let's see what it's at now. I think it's only at 2. 3. I'm gonna put it at 2. No, it's fine. Alright, I'll put it back. Put it to 100. Dang, I put Halloween jams on and these are some fresh Halloween vibes. I don't think this one's gonna be a good run. Good round. Come on. Loud commercials on this. Sometimes it even seems like they increase the volume of the commercials on purpose. The TV does that a lot. Scares the heck out of me. I think I might just reset. If that wasn't a horse, I'm just gonna reset. Nothing's even come in yet. I think maybe one. Maybe what I need to do is try and not go all the way back, so I have less lightning strikes out there and just around this area. Like maybe start the tracks right there. Like a quarter of the way from each end. That would be the center. And then maybe only go out to this second, not this one, but these next red ones. Only to right here. This way I'm not loading lightning strikes way out there. I used to have these train tracks go all the way to the end. But I did notice that if I do start the farm down here, lightning starts right away. I just gotta mess with this some more. I said I was gonna leave, huh? So what are you doing after this stream? Probably gonna do some cleaning, a little bit of studying, then get ready for when my kids come home from school. Mostly just a chill day. Hoping not to be on here too long, just an hour or so, but this is kind of what happened last time. Actually, this is exactly what happened last time. There has to be a way to increase the odds of getting more light, like to where more of the lightning strikes are spawning trap horses. There's a lot of lightning strikes that happen, especially real close to the player or within the farm vicinity. But not too many trap horses spawning in, except that one time when there was like 9 or 10. Like a slow cinematic little movie going around. Lucky on this one. What do you think, Alex? You think this is it right here? Send some luck this way so I don't keep having to have a boring live stream. It has been going back and forth nonstop on here. Alex says, me too, I'm having a chill day. Take breaks on Minecraft. Nice, dude, nice. Yeah, coming on here helps me to go ahead and have more of a stress-free day if possible. Like, my mind likes to think a lot, so I try and come on here to try and get a break from my mind constantly running, if that makes any sense. As you can see how much I do on here, it's really running even on this game. That's a good thing and a bad thing. Both fortunately and unfortunately. You gonna eat a bunch of candy, bro? You are doing fine. I appreciate that, Alex. Thank you, dude. I appreciate that.
On ads helps brands reach new audiences. Be there during Thursday Night Football, now on Prime Video. Tap into creator-first content on Twitch, or show up when they stream their favorite shows or playlists. You can be in the mix during the moments that matter to them.
When I first started trying to get the lightning to strike more commonly, I had my second account loaded in, and I have my wither based obsidian farm in the end dimension. I have it to where the player gets flushed into the end dimension and then automatically clicks. I put a rubber band on my controller and automatically clicks into the minecart, and the minecart gets powered on and then goes and automatically ejects the player into the end portal to go ahead and come back to the overworld. And then I have the bed spawning. Ooh, there was nothing again. I have the bed, the player spawning from where the last bed is, and be swept automatically back into the end portal. So I was using that to go ahead and load all the whole end dimension. Well, first unload the area where the end portal is. While first player is here, the second player will be unloading the end portal area, going into the end dimension, which is loading the whole end dimension. And then that would trigger the game to want to almost trigger all those lightning strikes at once to happen here. And then the second player would be flushed to come back to the overworld, which would unload the end dimension, loading the overworld, and cause the same thing to happen again in the sky. But that caused so much lag to where it was almost impossible. It's not impossible, but to where it made it annoying, I guess, to try and have both players constantly load in, run both controllers each time. And then if I don't get no luck like how it is here, that's already over an hour's worth of doing that. So I had to try and find some. And then plus being split screen, I'd have to have the stream being split screen or playing split screen. So I had to try and figure out some kind of way to go around that, but still have it closer to efficient. We'll see what this one is. And I'll have to restart. And Alex says, yes, I eat a lot of candy. Nice, nice, me too. These are one of the days I try and give myself the okay to have more candy than I normally would. I don't really eat too much candy like I used to. But on this day and the couple days after, I will for sure. Especially if it's chocolate. I really like chocolate. What kind of candies you like to have on this? Just in general. That was a shorter lightning storm too. Oh my gosh, I was just about to say I'm gonna change this for some Halloween music, and it really puts it on. I just press skip. Oh my goodness. Did this have one? I didn't even look. No, it's none. Oh, dang, that had a bunch of pumpkin heads. But then none of them are jack-o'-lanterns. That's the most I ever seen spawning with pumpkins, though. Just random candies. Nice, dude. Yeah, I guess that's the one thing about even just this time of year too, is there's always all kinds of random candies you get. Alright, let's go take a look. I don't think any of those were jack-o'-lanterns. Unfortunately, dang it. Could have been the one right there. Imagine all three of them just spawning with jack-o'-lantern heads and armor on. I need to make other farms to go ahead and try and get other mobs that have jack-o'-lantern heads. I need to try and get some from, let's see, all the mobs that I have that do have jack-o'-lantern heads are now the trap horses I have. I have wither skeletons that have jack-o'-lantern heads. I have, zombies, skeletons that have jack-o'-lantern heads, baby zombies that have jack-o'-lantern heads, drowns that have jack-o'-lantern heads. What else? There was one more. Oh, the husks, the zombies that spawn in the desert biomes. I have a couple of those that are jack-o'-lantern heads. I'd like to get one that's a skeleton riding a spider that has a jack-o'-lantern head. But I had to find that one, I think, naturally spawned in. I haven't made a spider farm on here. Like a spider-only farm. To see if I can get skeletons riding spiders like that. This farm, we've been trying to get something for probably almost an hour and a half now. And still haven't even had one jack-o'-lantern one. So with even with how many times I've restarted and exited and restarted, there's already been about, at least 30, maybe 40, maybe even 50 skeleton horses that have spawned in total this whole time. And then none of them have been jack-o'-lantern headed ones.
Thank you.
What are you doing in your world right now, Alex? You working on that, that chunk loader or that trading area? Are you playing right now? What are some other future plans you got with your world that you have in mind? Doing that chunk loader would be sweet. Especially if you're able to do it as you're planning to have it as minimal lag as possible. That'll be a good challenge right there. Said I am, but it's crashing multiple times. Dang, man. Sorry to hear that, bro. Does it only do it in certain areas, or like the game just crashes before you even get a chance to load in? Like, remember how I was mentioning with my world where I have a lot of shulker boxes? Like, now ever since Bedrock updated this past couple of times, on this version, I can't be around a bunch of shulker boxes trying to load in first for whatever reason. I don't know. And I don't know if it does that on Bedrock for you all or not. I remember one time about a year ago, there was an update where, no, probably like 2 years ago, where shulkers in both Bedrock version and this version game, I stopped playing until they fixed it. I think that was like a month, maybe a month and a half it took for them to do that. But to go ahead and try and salvage what and not lose anything, I decided just to not play. But see, that's all like Mojang's errors right there. They just gotta leave the game alone. Like, imagine in real life if people would just leave the game alone and not mess with stuff, things would probably be way different. People probably wouldn't be lagged behind in life. Dang, that's some real deep. That's something real deep right there. Dang. You said same here. It does it on chest. Okay, see, that might be where are you trying to load in? Internet quality is not sufficient to broadcast gameplay. Oh, hopefully that doesn't get ruined. I don't know why that's doing that, but if for some reason, bro, that causes an issue or with lagging, I apologize. And hopefully it doesn't crash me out or like disconnect on me. Are you loading in an area, like, are you trying to load in areas where there's a ton of chests, like, where you have your storage area, and that's why it's crashing? Or is the game just crashing as you're trying to even, to load up the game in general? There was a dolphin. Like, even now, if I go and fly, like, to main spawn, as soon as I'm, like, gliding in, it lags, like, super heavy. Because then it's trying to load everything in, and then all those shelter boxes just really, really slow it down. But that never happened before until they updated it. I have areas where there's tons of shelter boxes, like literally like hundreds, and they're all full, and it doesn't do that. It didn't do that before. It wouldn't slow down at all. Yeah, There's only been one horse on this one. Not a single horse. Says yes, I'm trying to load up for the storage room. Already 37 double chest game legs. Yeah, maybe you gotta try what I've been trying to do is just go exit and save the game each time where you're not around that. I've even noticed that if I play the game, say like I am now for like almost 2 hours, and I'm around areas that have a lot of shulker boxes or a lot going on or a lot of like mobs stored up, over time the game starts to slow down and I'll have to exit the game and reset the game completely, like exit out of the whole game and close the application and restart completely, and then it kind of refreshes itself, so to say, almost like how it is when being on a computer, like if you're on an application too long and or even on a phone and you don't close out something for a while, it starts to build up too much cache, cache, like side storage, and starts to really slow down. So I've even been having to do that here and there. I might even have to make it to where I go and slowly move shulker boxes out of the way so I can go to areas without lag happening. I have to play the game like I don't have shulker boxes. Cause sometimes, yeah, it's on here. Sometimes that lag, dude, is just, it would crash every single time, like how you're saying. This one's not having any horses either. Come on. Oh, there's one. No, my speaker.
Discover your next great listen with audiobooks on Spotify. With over 300,000 titles to choose from, explore the genres that speak to you. Then select title and add them to your rotation. Once you've selected an audiobook, you can seamlessly switch between your favorite music, podcasts, and audiobooks in one app.
Jeez, so we had that round where there was like, what was it, 9 or 10 that spawned in? And now these past couple of times, there's been 1 or 2 that spawned in. That has to be one. Nope, past the blue one. Just iron helmets. No, that's already it. That's is just, they're getting shorter and shorter. Nothing. Let's see, Alex says, Chimi, I hope you have a great day with your family and kids, and have a great chill day, and I will see you later. See you, I'm going to take a break on PS4. Hey, bro, you know what? Thank you, dude. I appreciate that, man. I appreciate you stopping by and chatting and asking questions and just hanging out, bro. I hope you have a really good day, too, with your family, and be safe out there, man. If I don't catch you on here later, I'll see you on the next time. Hey, if you can, send me some of those screenshots of your area. I'd like to check out what you got going on. Again, I appreciate you stopping by, bro. Take care. See you later, man. Have a good day. I'm only gonna try and stay on until I get one, and I'm gonna get off. Take care, bro. He says, yeah, you too, bro. See ya. And I like the video. Thank you, man. I appreciate that. And I know it's a little boring going back and forth, but patience is something that has to come along with these kind of farms. Thank you, man. Take care, bro. Hopefully we can get something here soon. Seems like a chill beat. Finally, there comes one. Come on, some good luck right here. Just looking for one. Ooh, that wasn't a strike. I mean, that wasn't one. That was a strike, of course, but that wasn't a trap horse one. Come on. Nope. Iron helmet again. Let's get going. Shoot, sorry, that was loud. Guardian. Jeez, I'm getting more guardians than trap horses. Close. He'll probably despawn because we're going too far now. Whoa. Despawned? Yeah, he's gone. Yes, there's finally one. Alright, hopefully this is it right here. Then we can call it a day. Please. Oh, let's see, come on. I can't see it, no. Turn around. Quick. Alright, we'll have to see on the way back. Hopefully that's it. Dang, that should have been one. Let's see. No! Still not, dang. Still not. Whoa. I was hoping that was it. That's it, gonna restart. I think I'll probably give it two more rounds. And then I'll cut this, I'll end this stream there. Two more rounds. Each round's about 10 minutes, so. I was hoping to be off within an hour. Thank you.
can do anything or anyone, but Crypto Carl or Grace the Ghoster? At Match, we believe the most important relationship you have is with yourself. So we say, do you. From self-care to self-love, doing you is a sign of self-respect. And matching with someone who knows what they want and wants them for less, that's sexy as hell.
Let's see, finally, come on. Hopefully we get back in time. The house is gonna open up under the underwater. Come on. No, went in. Maybe that'll be the lucky one, come on. Jack-o'-lantern still? No, come on. Hopefully that one under there is. Careful, squid. Thank you. It's a longer rainstorm, but not too many trap horses. Dolphin? That was a longer, way longer rainstorm. Hopefully, I know there's one down there that's not open. And this one coming. I don't see any more. Sometimes they can spawn way over there in the corner, though. I'll go back one more, back and forth one more time. Just to make sure. Jack-o'-lanterns. Nothing out there. Alright, I'll ride this back to the middle, jump down, and see if anything pops out of that middle one. Out of that closed one. Yeah, this will be the last round. I mean, after this one will be the last round. These guys don't have their shoes on either. Alright, exit. Last time. Then I'm gonna go ahead and end the stream after this one. So, hopefully last time's a charm. This is like 25 times already. If not more. Probably about 25, 30 times already. Well, maybe not that much, maybe like 20. Excuse me. Last round. Big luck, no whammies. Comes one to the right. See what this is. Two of them. There's one pumpkin one. Another one's just iron helmets. Pointing at me, they could see me.
about getting a better night's sleep. Carol doesn't know what size package to order. Luckily, her laptop company uses Zoom contact, so she messages a rep. The rep
to connect.
nothing. Just those first two, and that's it. I think when I hop off, I'll go into my creative test world and try and shorten this ramp and see if that makes a difference. Just make it to where it's maybe from this first powered rail to that last powered rail. And see if I can get more lightning spawns just in this general area instead of outside the farm. Still nothing. Simply find what you like and purchase Dolphin. To unlock titles, tap the banner to learn more. That's it. I'll go back up and down one last time and see if any spawned on the outsides or the outskirts. Nothing out there. Well, unfortunately, we didn't. This whole 2 hours, we didn't get none. No jack-o'-lanterns. There's one from the past. Some past times. There's one I have already. Two. And that's it. From past years. Well, I thank you all for who tuned in, Alex. I appreciate you tuning in and chatting. And I appreciate anyone who else who takes some time to take a look at this. I know it's a boring stream going back and forth, but certain mobs are rare and only come one time a year. So I'm trying to go ahead and go for it. We go for rares. You got to put that patience and effort in. Hope everyone has a good holiday. Please take care, and we'll see you all next time. Take care.